square root of a number. Hello friends, in this video we will learn what is square root and how do we find the square root using the repeated subtraction method. These 64 students have been selected for a parade in the school. In the parade, they have to walk in rows so that each row has as many students as the total number of rows. That is, if the total number of the rows is n, then the number of students in each row should be n. Here the total number of students is 64. If the students stand in such a rectangular form, then the total number of rows and the number of students in each row will not be the same. This can only be possible in a square structure. So in this case, how many rows should be there? We have learned how to find the square of numbers in the previous video. If there are n students in a row and there are n such rows, then the total number of students will be n times n equals n to the power of 2, that is, square of n, which we also call n square. Here, the square of n is given as 64. But we have to find the value of n here, that is, a number whose square is equal to 64. A number whose square will be equal to 64 will be called the square root of 64, which we represent as such. If 2 times 2 is equal to 4, then the square root of 4 will be 2. Finding the square root is the inverse operation of squaring. Now you have seen that the square root of 4 is 2. Is it the only possible square root of 4? The square of minus 2 is also 4. So minus 2 is also a square root of 4. We can say that a natural number n has two square roots, one positive and one negative. Positive and negative square roots are shown as follows. Now we will go back to our first question. Here, we have to find the value of n whose square, that is the square of n, is equal to 64. That is, we need to find the square root of 64. We can find the square root by several methods. But in this video, we will use the method of repeated subtraction. Suppose we are given a perfect square number, that is square of n. We know that the sum of the first n and consecutive odd numbers is equal to the square of n, which we can write in this way. And we can see that when we subtract them from this square number, we get 0. So we subtract odd numbers starting from 1 and see how many consecutive odd numbers have to be subtracted from it to reduce it to 0. The number of consecutive odd numbers required to reduce it to 0 is the square root of the given square number. 64 minus 1 is equal to 63. Then 63 minus 3 is equal to 60. Similarly, 15 minus 15 at the end will give us the figure 0. We saw that by subtracting the first 8 consecutive odd numbers from 64, we get 0 at the end. This shows that the number 64 is a perfect square number, and because we get 0 by subtracting 8 consecutive odd numbers here, so the square root of the number 64 is 8. So, in the parade, the students will stand in 8 rows and each row will have 8 students. The square root of the number 64 can be both 8 and minus 8. But because here we are talking about the number of students, in this case, only the positive square root will be taken. Now if some more students come for the parade on the second day, the total number of students now becomes 144, which is a perfect square number. So how many rows of students will be formed in this situation so that the total number of rows and the total number of students in the rows is equal? To find the answer, use the repeated subtraction method. First, subtract the consecutive odd numbers from the number 144. Count all the odd numbers up to the number that gives 0 when you subtract the consecutive odd numbers. Here we are getting 0 by subtracting 12 consecutive numbers. So the number 12 is the square root of 144. So now, the students will have to stand in 12 rows and each row will have 12 students each. In this video, we learned how to find the square root of numbers using the repeated subtraction method. In the next video, we will see some examples related to it. Thank you.